off race fans, here we go. The Bobcat Dirt Late Model, 25 laps in length. Adam Scoggins, big kill, bring him out of turn four for the green flag. The green flag flies. We have trouble on the front straightaway. A lot of parked cars. Looks like the worst one out there might be Baby Cagle in the 8 car, as it just wasn't a start that they wanted back in the mid to the last field. So Baby Cagle looks like he's moving around real good. And the thumbs up being given from Motorsports Rescue. Everybody's fine down in the race car. When we go from the beam getting to the field, we're fixing to go. Great late model racing once more. 25 laps. The picture is alive, been turned out. Adam Scoggins in big deal. Taking in turns 3 and 4. Pointing the bony finger, which means we're going green this time by. The field once more going down the back straightaway. Adam Scoggins, Vic Hill behind them, Corey Norman and Patrick Dugan. The Munger boys in row 3 as they go into turn 3. Going to get the green flag this time by. 25 laps of racing at Atomic Motor Speedway. waiting Stephen Harrison. Thank you. There you have it. What a race. Going on back in the back, but Vic Hill, car number one. Let's give a big hand. Vic Hill, your feature winner tonight. He looks a little excited in there. Well, right now, as of course, this was two features run tonight. There was points awarded in both races. And it looks like Vic Hill and Patrick Biggin have pretty much set the pace for as far as the point standings go. It looks like Vic Hill may, well, he will be our point leader after tonight because he got a first place finish and a third place finish, with Patrick Biggin getting a first place finish and a fourth place finish. So Vic Hill, you're unofficial, of course, but I can pretty much say it's pretty official.
You're just making it up as you go along, aren't you?
That's right. But Vic Hill, congratulations.
Out of Monson, Tennessee, putting it out front. Yeah, we had a pretty good run tonight. When we qualified, we pushed real bad and just had a terrible lap qualifying. And it was real good hot lapping, so we just changed a few little things in the first race. You know, we came from 13th or wherever to 3rd, and the car was real good, and we didn't do anything but put some gas in it, grind the tires, and went back out, and it was good. But whatever you did, it seemed like it worked, got it dialed in. You looked the best you've looked all year. You looked pretty good in your open motor car. It's a Thunder 100, but this is the best I've seen you look in the steelhead.
Well, we've had, we qualified good in the steelhead and just not raced real good, and same deal with the open car. And talked to Ronnie Stuckey a little bit. It helps Mark Vineyard, and he told me some different shocks maybe to try, and we put them on tonight, and it definitely did the job.
Well, you got out front and led the way. There was a fierce battle going on for second, third, and fourth behind you. And which really kind of helped you get out front and just checked out on them. And I tell you, we're glad to have you down here this year, and we hope you'll be back competing for the points all year.
Well, you know I will, as long as I'm winning.
That's right. Back up to you, Ken. As long as he's winning, he'll